Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. God is good. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I thank you for your goodness, mercy, and grace, and love to us, Father. Hallelujah. Our Lord Jesus, when he walked here in this earth, many people followed him. The multitude followed him, said the Bible, many occasions. He performed many miracles, signs and wonders in front of them. But we know that not all the people to follow Jesus or seek for Jesus just were following because it was Jesus, the Messiah, or they want to learn from him. Many of them, they just follow Jesus or seek Jesus for the thing he did, for the miracles, for the bread, for the fish.
Yeah.
And that happened now. People seeking Jesus for the blessings. That was many seek for Jesus, follow Jesus, because they want something from Jesus, material things. And disappointment, right? Jesus have done great things for us.
Amen.
He died for on the cross.
Amen.
He gave his life for us. He left heaven for us and came here on this earth to live like us men and suffer a great deal to rescue us.
Amen.
Amen. But really, like the sun said, he don't owe anything to us.
Come on.
If we follow, we have to be sincere in our seeking of Jesus.
Amen.
Follow him because who he is.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We have to get all of us as believers, we have to get to that place.
Amen.
And the more we know him, the more we start to get away from our life, other wrong model, why we are seeking him.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Open your Bible in John chapter 6. Say amen. Were you there?
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Say the word of God. Say the word of God. Amen. Say John 6. We start in verse 22. Hallelujah. On the following day, when the people who were standing on the other side of the sea saw that there was no other boat there except that one with his disciples had entered and that Jesus had not entered the boat with his disciples, but his disciples had gone away alone. However, other boats came from Tiberias, near the place where they ate bread after the Lord had given thanks. Remember the multiplication of the bread?
Amen.
He said, multiply the bread for them. When Jesus was preaching to them and was many days passed and there were people were hungry, and Jesus multiplied the bread for them there. Amen. They just remember that. They were looking for Jesus, right? Seeking for Jesus. Where Jesus? Where Jesus? Let's read verse 24. Verse 24.
Amen.
When the people therefore saw that Jesus was not there, nor his disciples, they also got into boats and came to Capernaum seeking Jesus. We can say, you know, they're sincere seeking for Jesus. Look, they're desperate for Jesus. Let's see, Jesus know what's in the main hearts.
Amen.
He know everything.
That's right.
He knows our thoughts. Nobody can fool Jesus, right? Bukankran, Kanchao. But Jesus knows what is there in the heart of man.
Amen.
That they are seeking for Jesus. Jesus. Sometimes people go to great dig seeking for Jesus, but that's for the wrong motive. Verse 25, and when they found him on the other side of the sea, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you come here? Verse 26, Jesus answered them and said, most assuredly, I mean, that's Ezekiel, that's like what I'm going to tell you. This sure what I'm going to tell you. Most actually, I say to you, you seek me, you see, not because you saw the signs. Remember, Jesus performed a lot of signs and wonder miracles in front of them. He multiplied the fish, the bread. Okay? And Jesus know the hearts of men. Jesus know the heart of each of us.
That's right.
Others are not their heart, our hearts, but we have in our hearts, but we think right now. You know, sometimes good things are not for the right motive. People do think they appear good, but it's not the right motive.
That's right.
Jesus answered them and said, most assuredly I say to you, you seek me not because you saw the signs, but because you ate of the loaves and were filled. Jesus, that's what the moral. They were seeking for Jesus. They went all that deal, you know, all that thing to go and boat, get in boat, and, you know, and go to the other side. We don't know if everybody had a boat or they had to rent a boat. Somebody had to train them, but they went seeking for Jesus. And we see something like that, we say, oh, those people really love Jesus. Like we see in church. People crying, people hollering, people jumping around. They love Jesus. Mm-hmm. You know, that's where we find people that they always say the truth. Jesus always say the truth.
Come on.
You're not to offend nobody. Offend, you know, I know what's in your heart. I know what's in your heart. You know. You know what's in your heart, you know what's in my heart.
That's right.
Most assuredly I said to you, you seek me not because you saw the signs, but because you ate of the loaves and were filled. Okay? They want more. They want more bread. They want more fish, free bread. These are not the intent why they were seeking for him. Why you seeking Jesus for? Why you go to church? Why you pray? Why you worship? Why? Jesus knows, but why you do you know you are you sincere you are you seeking Jesus because who he is? You don't need to answer that question to me, you answer yourself.
That's right.
And when Jesus asks the question to us, it's not because he doesn't know the answer. He knows the answer.
Yes.
He knows.
Amen.
He wants you to know, you say, well, he unveiled your heart, he wants you to see your heart.
That's right.
Remember when Jesus asked question, when the Father asked a question to us, it's not because they ignorant of the things. They know everything.
That's right.
He knows everything.
Amen.
So when Jesus asked you a question about you being sincere about it,
amen.
Verse 27. Do not labor for the food which perishes. You see. Do not labor. Do not strive for those things that perish for material things. You see, people seek Jesus, seek the Father for material things, for natural things. And they strive for those things. And Jesus said, do not labor for the food which perishes. He's talking not only by the food, the bread, the fish, for material things,
that's
for natural
right.
things.
Come on.
People go to all extent for material things, they, you know. Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endure to endure to everlasting life. Yes. Will you ask in the things of honor and the things of the earth? Remember that?
Yes.
Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endure for everlasting life, with the Son of Man will give you, because God the Father has set his seal on him. Amen? And we see that Jesus telling us, like telling them, those people that were following with him, seeking for him, is telling us today to this church, don't seek me for material things.
Amen.
And I speak of them, I'm speaking with people, with believers. They come to me always seeking for material things. When talk about God, it's about material things. I need this, I need that. I want God to give me this. I want Jesus to do this for me. You see, that's the spiritual relationship with Jesus. That's the relationship they have with Jesus, about material things. That's the relationship with Jesus. When they pray for it because they want something, some material things, natural things. That's not a relationship.
Amen.
That is not a relationship. Imagine if someone, let's say husband and wife relationship, and the wife comes to husband only when they need money, or would you buy me this? That's the only conversation they have. That's the only relation that they have. You see, that's the only intimacy they have about material things. And many believers, that's the kind of the relationship that with the Father and with Jesus is about material things. They seek him for material things. They're looking for him for material things. They follow him for material things. Even to go to the church is for material things. I came here to be blessed. And when they talk about blessing, now they're not talking about spiritual blessings. They're talking about material things. And Jesus will answer to the people the same way he answered to those people in that time. Okay. You see me not because you saw the sun, but because you ate of the love and were filled. You're seeking me for material things. And again, what are you seeking Jesus for? You know, I was in a place. During the time in that place, the only thing that I heard from the preacher's mouth was about material things. Oh, the kingdom, the gospel is only about, for that person, only about material things. Nothing else. Material things. Seeking for things that perish, like Jesus said. We know people have needs. And God said we supply our needs according to riches and glories. Okay? And Christ Jesus. But that is not the focus of us. That's not a relationship with Jesus. That's not the foundation of relationships with Jesus, material things. Because if that's the foundation of relationship, or the person thinking that the only relationship they have with Jesus to receive something from Jesus, some material thing from Jesus, that's not a relationship, that's a sincere relationship.
Come on.
They're not a relationship at all.
Come on.
Like relationship father and son, or father and daughter, mother and daughter, they only talk to their parents when they need something from them. The rest, they're not a relationship. You see that? It's not, it's true relationship there. They're not true relationship. The only we communicate each other when we need something from the other. The people, the time of prayers, some believers, the time of prayers only when they need something. When they need a miracle from Jesus. Not supposed to be that way. Only about material things. You know, we can call it a spiritual gold digger. Yeah. Spiritual gold digger, they go and ask their material things. Blessing. I want the blessing. But the whole relationship they have. I want to fast. Why you want to fast? Because I need something from Jesus. The Father sent Jesus to save us, but the people were seeking for Jesus for material things. You know, the relationship the people in the Old Testament with the Father, with God, was different than the relationship with the Father. Because in the New Testament, Jesus brought us close to the Father. And Jesus unveiled the Father to us. In the New Testament, they don't have that knowledge of the Father. But we as believers, as new creatures, we have the knowledge of the Father because Jesus unveiled the Father to us. And when Jesus, he started talking about the Father, he's telling my Father and your Father. You see? Bring us into relationship. And that's all about Christianity, it's about relationship.
Amen.
Know what I want. I'm not seeking for Jesus when I need something. When I'm in the pico, I need, you know. Oh, I'm seeking for Jesus. See? The multitude follow Jesus. For the wrong motto. And the multitude continue seeking for Jesus for the rumor, material things, rumor. And they didn't believe. The multitude, they seek for Jesus, but they don't believe. They really didn't believe. And many, and still the church, unbelievers in the church. There's still unbelievers in the church now.
Yes.
Let's read verse 28. verse 28, John 6, verse 28. Then they say to him, what shall we do that we may work the works of God? Jesus answered and said to them, this is the word of God, that you believe in him whom he sent. And you see, you know, belief is trust, dependency in Jesus. That's why Jesus telling you, you have to believe in the Son of God. Yeah. That's the word of God. Belief. And you cannot do the word of God without belief in Jesus. Verse 30, therefore they say to him, what sign will you perform? They ask him for more signs. Yeah. People always asking Jesus for a sign. It is written, everything is written. It is written. It is written who Jesus is, it is written who God is. We don't need to ask for signs.
Amen.
And those people, they saw signs and wonder. They saw it. No one, not two, many signs and wonders. Many. As it's written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Okay, you see? And Jesus gave them bread. No one. And they asked him for more. He said, you know, our Father, give bread in the desert. And Jesus gave bread to them too. He multiplied the bread and the faces, and they were filled. And they still do not believe. See, the heart have been touched near their mind. They are still blind because I see they were in front of the Son of God. They were in front of the Messiah. Many believers have experienced great things from God, but they are still do not believe. They are still bad. I need a sign. It is written.
Amen.
You know, something they already written and they're asking for a sign. Just believe and obey. Walk by faith. But they go and they try to be like, for this guy. And the Old Testament, he had four signs to the Father. You see, don't compare yourself with that guy, or Gideon. You experience salvation. You're a new creature.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit inside of you, the kingdom of God is inside of you. Verse 22, then Jesus said to them, most assuredly I say to you, Moses did not give you the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Yeah, I hear. See, all those things that Jesus, you know, people say, I want to see miracles, believe. Some people are going to see miracles, signs and wonders, they're never going to believe. Unbeliever as believers. They're not going to believe. You know, signs and wonders can bring people to. But many, they're not going to believe, even they see signs and wonders. They even got to miracle in their life, and then they forgot who's God. I've been witnessing the people that they God do great things in their life, but they live like it. Nothing happened in the life like you. That's the sign that they did not believe. That's the sign. And those people here, the same. And the same thing happened in the church. Verse 34, then they say to him, Lord, give us the bread always. Yeah, they just talking. Like the church, many people, they just are talkers. They just like to talk. They just come with all kinds of words, by words. They don't mean nothing. Like, Lord, manifest yourself to me. You don't believe the word. You want to believe manifestation. Like, Lord, touch me. This word. And Jesus, verse 25, Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Who comes to me shall never hunger. Who believes in me shall never thirst. Verse 26, Jesus said, but I said to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. But I say to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. These are new they had, right? They were talking. Give me the breath. Always. No, you're not going to believe. I will continue to change signs and wonders, you're not going to believe. The church, I see too much of God. And some part of the church do not believe. And Jesus knows that. The part of the church full of unbelief. They seeking Jesus, they seeking their Father for material things. And they do all kinds of things, you know, and they appear to be spirituals. With the long prayers, you know, all this thing they do to appear spirituals, but Jesus not theirs. You know, they be loud, thinking about be loud and more faith. No, they don't have no faith. Long prayer, they think the faith, no faith. Jesus calling all of us to check our heart and see what we're seeking Him for.
Amen.
Are we seeking Him for He is the Lord, our Savior, the King of the world, the Son of God? Or we are seeking Him for material things? Or are we in all, any kind of need? Many believers have to revise the relationship with God and Jesus. They have to revise. They are too time to see what kind of relationship they have with Jesus, with the Father. See, and not the same because people go to meetings, they don't mean that they have a relationship. They can go to a meeting, four meetings during the day, church meeting on the day. They don't mean that they're in relationship with Jesus. Okay. I met many of those. They did not believe. They always be bad. And Jesus telling them, just believe. Believe in the song. It is written. Meditate on this. Maybe think about your relationship with Jesus. Meditate. Give a deep talk about this. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.